गो फॉर दी क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. हाँ, शब्दास दी सर्व शब्द एंड अदर शब्दास वी विल डू टुमारो. विल सी व्हाट इज मेंट बाय नप्ता. नप्ता इज ग्रैंडसन फ्रॉम दी मदर साइड. कैन वी यूज चतुर्थी एज कर्तृपदम. ध्रुवाय नारायणे भक्ति अस्ति. ध्रुवाय नारायणे भक्ति अस्ति. ध्रुवस्य नारायणे भक्ति अस्ति इत्येव साधु साधु प्रयोगः. श्रीराम महोदयः, हाउ डू वी अंडरस्टैंड द मीनिंग्स ऑफ धातुस. सो मीनिंग्स ऑफ धातुस इज टू बी गॉट फ्रॉम दी पाणिनीय धातुपाठा और डिक्शनरीज. दैट इज द ओनली वे टू गेट दी मीनिंग ऑफ धातुस. धन्यवाद.
I have one additional question, if you don't mind.
Who is this, sir?
Sriram.
Sriram.
Right. I'm just in continuation with that question.
Okay.
My question was, there is Dhatupata says only gati or gatav as the meaning, but in dictionaries and other places you get additional meaning, just like for lik dhatu. Lik dhatu is given as gatav in one of the listings I saw of the Dhatupata. But lik, as we understand it, is to write, to scratch and things like that. How are these additional meanings given, or is it listed in another listing of the dhatus? Is there another listing where these meanings are given, is my question.
So the popular meanings are given in the Dhatupata. Likha Akshara Vinyase is the popular meaning. But the other meanings are derived from the prayogas, from the usages,
okay,
which is prior to Panini. There may be some usage in the Vedas, in the Itihasa Puranas.
So there is no additional listing.
There is
no additional listing like the Dhatupata that gives meanings, that give this additional meanings to the same dhatus, is what I'm asking.
There is a book called Akhyata Chandrika,
okay,
which is a very recent book done by some people in Chinmaya and Kerala, some grammarians in Kerala, where they have tried to group the verbs based on the meanings.
Thank you.
So, Akhyata Chandrika is the name
Dhaniwad.
Of the book.
Akhyata
that, book
Chandra.
Also, that book also tries to give based on the meanings. So if you say Gatav, how many dhatus are there with the meaning of Gatav? All that is listed at one place. And then you take some other dhatu, it is listed at one place. So this kind of book is there. Then Upasargartha Chandrika. There is one more book called Upasargartha Chandrika. When we add Upasargas, the meaning changes. We'll be studying about Upasarga in next week class. So that also is listed in another book called Upasargartha Chandrika by Charudev Shastri. So it is a very ancient book, say 80 years old. It's not available now. It's out of print. In archive.org, you may get it.
Dhanyavada, Maharaya.
Dhanyavada. So I will just lower all the hands and see whoever has got only questions can raise the hand. Sitaram Subramanyam.
In the Shanti Mantra, Swasti Prajabhyam. That Prajabhyam is in which vachana it is?
Swasti Prajabhyah. Swasti is chatur. Swasti, when Namaswasti Swaha Swadhanam Vashat Yogacha. So when Swasti comes, Prajabhyah should be in Chaturthi. You have learnt that too.
Another question is, in Dukkha, why is that Visarga there? Du, upper Du, Visarga is there.
Visarga is there, we have to pronounce it. Dukkha, the pronunciation itself is dukkha. The word, the swarupa of the word itself is dukkha. We have to pronounce along with the visarga actually, dukkha. But that visarga should not, is heard only little. Dukkha, you can't pronounce like that. It will take a lot of time. Dukkha, that's all you have to pronounce. Lata Vidyaranya.
Namaste Mahodaya. I have a doubt about the usage of Shashti Vibhakti when we greet a group of people. Some people say Sarvebhyaha Namaskaraha. they use chaturthi. Some people use sarvesham namaskarah shashti. Are both the usages correct, or how do we do it?
So namaskara is a different word, namaha is a different word. When namaha avyaya is used, we have to use chaturthi. Definitely the rule is chaturthi. Namaskaraha is a kridanta word. So it's a different word. Namaskaraha is not equal to namaha.
Here sarve bhyaha namaskaraha anta heltara, ellarigo, that is chaturthi torustade. Sarve cham namaskaraha, when we say it, is showing ellara anta kannadadalli artha bandibuttala. So I got confused.
Translation is not the right way of learning Sanskrit. So translation may not give the desired result.
Okay. So both we can use sarvebhyah namaskarah, sarvesham namaskarah also.
So
okay.
Yes, we can use both.
And one more doubt. Here you said something about gnapya, gnapya and gnapaka. So in a sentence like udite suryaha sati andakaraha nashtaha, so andakaraha nashtaha becomes gnapaka and udite suryaha becomes gnapya, is it?
No, it is reverse. Gnapya is that which you want to remember. Helps you remember is gnapaka.
Okay. I was confused. And this Sati Saptami, is it something like yada, tada? When you yada something happens, tada, some.
Yada, tada. But here it is a different context. Here you want to indicate the remembrance of actions. In yada, tada, it is when, then. That is an avyaya prayoga. This is a namapada prayoga.
Dhanyavada, Mahode.
Ujit Nayar.
Mahode, in the case of dukkha, that jihvamulya has to be used while pronouncing?
Dukkha, yes, jihvamulya, ardha or quarter visarga, we have to pronounce dukkha.
Dhanyavada.
Sudarshan Srinivasachar. Sudarshan Srinivasachar. Please unmute yourself, sir. We are unable to hear you, sir. I tried unmuting you even in the class. Your voice is not heard. Your mic is not functioning. Dhanyavada. Okay, I think this finishes the questions. Sarita Bhagini has got a question. Let us see what she has to ask. Sarita Bhagini.
Guruji, when you said in the translation of the shloka, just before that, the sentences, and you in the translation, when and while, you added that. So which words indicate, or do we just add because it is the sapni, sati?
Which shloka is it?
No, just before shloka, the translation Rama Vasati.
Rame Gate Dasharatha.
No. After this, I think it was when something happened, you came in the Sati Saptami, I think.
That is coming. That is why that Lata Vidyaranya, she asked one question. No? Yada Tada. So this Saptami Vakti itself, since it is indicating and helping to remember two actions,
right,
but when and the thing then come is coming along with that, along with that Saptami Vritti, it is coming. Therefore, we do not go by the translation, but we go by the rule.
Okay. Thank you.
So, if you are, your question is there a word which indicates when in the sentence? There is no direct word indication in the sentence.
Okay.
However, the contextual meaning of one action helping remember the other action gives the meaning of when.
Okay.
In this sentence.
Okay. Right. I understand. Yeah. Thank you. And can I ask one more thing?
Please.
You mentioned that book. the e-book that we can buy online.
Okay.
So I was trying to look into that, and it says you cannot download. But I can keep it on my laptop and read it whenever I like.
Yes, it is a flip book. The technology will not allow you to download.
Yes.
So if you want, either you can buy the hard copy, which you can have in the hand. But yeah. If you are outside India, you can buy the flip book.
Huh.
You cannot download that one. You can
right. So flip if and I use buy it the, like a, use right. It like so a, if I buy the flip book, it will be on my laptop. How do I access it then?
There'll be a password and username which will be sent to you. You can keep on accessing it throughout your life.
Okay.
But you should have a system or a mobile to access it.
Okay, is a special system?
No, any Windows Mac system.
Any Windows. Okay, thank you.
Dhanyavaad.
Quick question on that, sir. Is that also accessible on a tablet or like an Android phone or iPad? The flipbook?
Android, it is not an Android app. First thing is, it is not an app.
Okay.
So Android.
No, but can I access it through Android
phone,
like with a browser or something like that?
Yes,
or?
Yes. Browser you can access. Browser you can access.
Okay. It can be through accessed through a browser, but not as an app.
Not as an app.
Okay. Thank you.
Dhanyavaad.